Phil Bailey, Phil Collins together on BFBS Radio 2. And Easy Lover. It's coming up to 7 minutes past. Now, a leading global economic authority is warning the economy may be in more trouble than had been realised. The International Monetary Fund says the world economy will grow by less in the next year than at any time since the Second World War. And most worryingly for us, Britain is set to be worse affected than any other advanced country. Jonathan Davis is Managing Director of Financial Planners, Armstrong Davis. Jonathan, this is a pretty bleak forecast, isn't it?
You call it bleak. I would call it finally the IMF waking up to economic reality. All the mainstream forecasters have been so positive, unrealistically, for the past couple of years, whilst we've been in the biggest credit bubble of all time, it was inevitable that it was going to burst. There has never been a bubble in economic history that hasn't burst. They never deflate. And it's interesting, you quote them as saying the economic growth will be negative. No, it'll be a fall. Economic activity will fall by 2.8%, according to them, and I think they're pretty well finally on the mark.
Why is it then, Jonathan? I mean, you're obviously aware of what's been happening over the last number of years or so, saying we've been living in a credit bubble and this was always going to happen. Why is it that the Chancellor, the former Chancellor, now the Prime Minister, was quite happily marching along and saying, you know, this is not going to happen, this is not going to happen. And then a couple of weeks or so ago, we hear him say, well, yes, it is worse than I had actually thought it was going to be.
An excellent question, and I might remind your listeners that in 1997 he said he will never let house prices get out of control, and in the last few years he said and repeated he has ended boom and bust. Well, what a stuff of nonsense. In answer to your question, votes. But, you know, it's not just Brown, it's Bush across the water, it's every country, they all go for votes. And they all want to pretend that there's not a problem. But in fact, globally, every developed country, and indeed developing country, allowed people, companies and governments to borrow beyond belief. And now, you know, well, in the last 10 years, actually, we've had a party. And now, unfortunately, we're having the biggest hangover in probably 80 years.
But this is still going on now, this almost is head in the sand business, because this prediction of a 2.8% contraction in the UK contrasts quite markedly with the Treasury's own forecast.
Yes, you're absolutely correct. The pre-budget report in November, Darling was saying that by the second half of this year, the economy would start growing again. Well, I don't want to use the word that I'm thinking of on air, but let's say I disagree entirely. We have the biggest recession since the 1930s. We have the fastest growing unemployment, unfortunately, since 30 years. We have the biggest falling retail sales in 30 years. This country will be in recession throughout the whole of this year, and I think significantly into 2010, although clearly it's difficult to forecast exactly.
Jonathan, what is this going to mean then for the man on the street or for the soldier serving overseas or whatever? And I suppose we could focus on housing because, you know, this is the biggest thing that we buy in our lives.
Well, absolutely, and it's because the United Kingdom has had the biggest housing bubble in the developed economies. It's therefore the reason why we're going to have the biggest bust. We're going to see a vast rise in unemployment. We're already way past 2 million. I can see that going above 3 million by next year. We've already seen vast swathes of the high street go under. I'm afraid to say that's going to continue. Look, people must be under no illusion. This is deadly serious. You don't have the biggest financial institutions in the world going bust unless it is deadly serious. In relation to house prices, well, they're already down around 20% since the high in August 2007. And my firm is forecasting that they will bottom out in about 2 years' time, 2011, and they will be 40 to 50% below the highs. In other words, in the summer of 2007, a £300,000 house will be something like £150,000 to £180,000.
Those are terrifying figures.
Well, it depends on your point of view. If you recently, in the last few years, traded up or bought for the first time with a huge mortgage, then yes, you're frankly in great difficulty. Of course, if you're renting, you're laughing.
Hmm. Just to finish off, if we might please, Jonathan, a crunch question for the forces. What might this all mean for the exchange rate with the euro?
Well, as everyone undoubtedly knows, it's already collapsed beyond belief. I think the European countries are not actually as strong as some might suggest. Spain, Ireland, Italy, they have got colossal economic problems, broadly similar to ours. So when you average it out, the euro actually isn't necessarily going to continue strengthening against sterling. In other words, I think we're probably there or thereabouts as to where we're going to be. We're currently about 106, 108 to the pound. And, you know, that's more or less where it's going to end up.
All right, Jonathan, thank you.
More or less.
Thank you, Jonathan. Jonathan Davis, Managing Director of Financial Planners, Armstrong Davis.